Boom, coming in hot, Chinchy. Back to the old stomping grounds, at the house. I just flew in from the network out of Newark this morning. It's pouring rain here, which is nice. My leaves aren't done yet, but it's still awesome, dude. I'm glad to be back in the saddle, back in the home base. Sometimes traveling gets old, bro.
I know, I hear that. Yeah, you're in a friendly confines. Well, for me, I'm really glad those gardeners came and disturbed everything, because I woke up this morning, there's leaves all over the ground again because it's the next day.
Are you serious? Shit.
Yes, of course I am. That's the biggest scam, the leaf collecting.
Dude, when I used to come home from school, my dad would be like, "Dad, you gotta do the leaves," and I'd be like, "Oh man, you know, you're a teenager, you don't want to do it." And he's like, "Man's only as good as his word. You said you'd do the leaves." I'm like, "Oh man," hits me with the guilt trip, bro. Funny. I don't know how you guys do it. We used to do the Jim Casey technique. Rake the leaves, then get in like doggy position and just start shoveling. You put the bag between your legs and you shovel them in. Boom. I see these people. I saw this guy the other day. Biggest scam ever. Mm-hmm. One of those like, it's like a funnel that goes in the thing and you take the leaves and you put the leaves in. I'm like, what a scam. I'm like, dude, get the bag between your legs, get the leaves, and just get in there like you're about to eat the leaves for an appetizer and just start shoveling.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Yes. How great was it when your kids started getting old enough to do their own chores? Is that the greatest part of your life?
Oh, dude, it's incredible. I still do it with the girls. I'm like, girls, because I don't love the dishes. And I'm like, girls, dishes in the morning. And they're like, Jillian doing the top, Carly doing the bottom. And I'm like, oh, yeah, perfect. The other day I had, I was in MLB Network, so I had to call because I had to get the garbage out. I'm like, girls, can you get the garbage out? And like, you know, I got that Ring camera. I see these two little girls. Boom. They got like, Jillian's like 12. The garbage can's bigger than her. She's rolling it up. My driveway is like Mount Vesuvius. It's like freaking straight up. You know what I mean?
That's so good. Anyway, hey, somebody did our work for us today. Our good friend, John Heyman. Great.
Thanks, Johnny.
Great article in the Post. If you guys haven't seen it, the New York Post, right? He basically rips off like every MLB star free agent, where they stand and where they could land. So you want to rip through that right now?
Yeah, bro. Let's do it.
All right. We'll make the first one short because I think we've talked about this a lot. And so really his big thing, Aaron Judge. Okay. He says the Giants look like the biggest threat to the Yankees. Farhan Zaidi made it clear they are in on big free agents to win them. And don't forget, they went after Harper hard a couple of years ago and didn't get him.
They've gone
after a couple of the biggest guys, and they haven't caught the white whale, but they clearly have the money for it. But whatever. I don't know. Let's be quick about that one. What do you think? Do you think he winds up in San Fran or New York?
You know what? The more I look at it, I'm starting to feel like he's not going to end up in New York. Okay. So it feels a little bit, I think San Francisco would be a great landing spot. Greg Amsinger last night on the network said he's going to the Mets because Stevie Cohen's like, day. You know what? I want to own New York. And if they don't want Judge, we'll take him.
Okay. Second one, very interesting to me. Trea Turner. Okay. The belief among Dodgers people is that they still have to overcome his East Coast bias. If geography counts, the Phillies may have the advantage. Trea Turner's wife is from New Jersey. This is why Heyman is so good. He goes, like, you don't think about that. Think about you as a human with a family and children and all that kind of stuff.
It matters big time. It matters big time.
Yeah, isn't that
right? That's why we moved to Pittsburgh. We moved back to Pittsburgh because we came here. My parents were here. They helped so much with the kids. We're like, this is so much easier than having family around.
Let's not forget, too. Remember when they signed Cliff Lee from Texas, and it was a big shocker, but it wasn't a shocker to the Lee family because I believe one of his children had a condition. And the hospital they wanted to send their child to was in Philadelphia. So that's why you forget the human element of these free agents.
I remember Austin Kearns. We had Austin Kearns on our podcast. His son had some, has autism. And I guess they had a great, facility at Cleveland Clinic. That was a big reason he was with the Indians.
Right.
And by the way, you're right. Dude.
Hey, Yankee Stadium is not very far from New Jersey, right? Not very far from Philadelphia. The question is, do the Yankees punt on the kids, or do you turn Volpe into a second baseman and go after Trea Turner? That's pretty strong thought.
Listen, I don't know. Listen, if you're the Yankees, Volpe's going to be a great player, but he's a couple years from being the player that you really want him to be. I think Volpe, you know, you can put Volpe at second base, and you already know you have an elite player at short.
Right.
You know, at the end of the day, that's where they were missing that. They were missing that. And, dude, Trea Turner is an elite player. So he's going to be great with the Yankees. Or I just can't get out of my mind where Bryce Harper said that, you know, after they lost the World Series, like, listen, John Middleton, Dave Dombrowski, they're not going to just sit back. Middleton's got the money. Mm-hmm. Dombrowski is a wheeler and dealer, bro. He's looking for star players. They will go get a, you know, and Harper was like, we're going to go get somebody.
Nice.
So to get a guy like Trea Turner, bro.
I think he might be, might be the most impactful guy on the market, even more so than Judge. I think so,
dude. Well, the speed power combo now. The guy's a power
threat. And the position,
right now.
He plays.
And he can play center, too.
Mm-hmm.
He can play center. You know, he's a guy that's going to steal bases for you, get on base. He's an unbelievable base runner. He's a game-changing bat.
Yeah.
He's a game-changing player.
You can argue that
Trea Turner to the Phillies is huge.
You can argue he's a bigger X factor than Aaron Judge.
And also, too, here's another thought about that. What about Xander Bogaerts to the Phillies?
Ooh.
Because Dave Dombrowski was with him in Boston, and you don't think Dave Dombrowski wants to stick it to Boston after they won and they kind of pushed him out. Uh-huh. Now he's in Philly and they're winning again. You don't think he'd love to bring Bogey there?
Mm-hmm.
And also, you never know down the line. They talk about Bogaerts and Devers being like two peas in a pod.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever one goes, the other goes.
Ooh.
He brings Bogaerts to Philly. Next, you know, Devers in a couple of years is the third baseman for the Phillies in that park.
Yeesh.
Dude, Fenway is not a lefty-friendly park.
Right.
That's why with Big Poppy knows, guys, if you're a lefty in Fenway, it's a bomb there. It's it's almost 390 to, like, kind of right.
Mm-hmm.
So Devers is losing. You got to crush it there. You can imagine in Philly?
Forget it.
To right field, bro?
Devers, that's a good one.
There's 10 home runs on his numbers.
I like that. Heyman mentions the Cubs as a possible landing spot as well for Bogaerts. So that's interesting.
Yeah,
here's one. I like that. Here's one. Who is this player right now? Carlos Correa. What are you getting out of Carlos Correa if you pick him up?
Carlos Correa, you're getting one of the best players in the game. You know, your best shortstops in the game, bro. He proved it this year with Minnesota, played 138 games. You know, this guy is a guy that, you know, he's a big-time player. He can hit. He hits for power. We've seen what he did in the postseason for the Astros. The reason he opted out is because he knows how good he is and kind of proved it in Minnesota. Right.
So
you're getting a great player. That, like, Yankees would be a good fit there for me. Like,
that would
he's
be a good one.
He's a big time player. He's not scared of the pressure. Uh-huh. Almost thrives in it.
Yep.
I think Correa, if Turner goes to Philly, Correa would be a nice spot for the Yankees. The Yankees got to land one of these guys though, bro.
Yeah, they certainly do, and
they really do.
Also, another name coming up for Correa that nobody really would talk about normally is going back to the Twins, because as Heyman reports, the owner is one of the richest owners in the game. So he might not be, they might be a small market team, but you get Scott Boras as your agent. I don't think you care what market you're in if you're getting the most money for your guy, right?
Good point. Good point. Yeah.
Thank you. DeGrom. Mm-hmm. Does he stay?
Yeah, going to be interesting.
Apparently he likes the Rangers, and the Rangers are in it to win it. They showed it last year by their offseason. They were very hardworking in the offseason. What about, you know, and don't forget, like, you think about your future. You get DeGrom there, and then maybe you call up our buddy Leiter a year early, and he gets to sit and just tie him to Jacob DeGrom and have him follow him around for 2 years. Yeah.
Jack Leiter hanging out with DeGrom. Let's go, man.
How about that as an option?
Well, dude, Texas is in, bro. They signed Simeon last year, and they signed Seager.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did they have the best of years? Simeon kind of came along in the second half. He just came out the gates so slow. Seager had ended up having a nice year. Probably not as good as what they paid for. But, dude, they're going for it. And at the end of the day, they need pitching. They just signed Odorizzi. You can't have Odorizzi and John Gray as your one and two. You gotta have some thunder.
They're
going for somebody, bro. They're gonna get Rodon. They're gonna get Verlander. They're gonna get DeGrom. They're gonna get some, because they're gonna overpay.
I love it.
Not overpay, but they're gonna give what the Mets gave Scherzer. They're gonna come in with something like that. You know, you give Verlander something like 3 years, $45 million a year. He's coming.
And Verlander's going back to Houston, right? He's not going to the Yankees. He'll stay in Houston, right?
I think he'll probably stay back in Houston.
I don't think he likes the Yankees. I don't think he likes New York.
But here's the Chinch. Here's the deal. Does Houston need him?
Ooh.
Look, dude, you still had
good point.
Urquidy, who's nasty, and Garcia in the bullpen.
Oh boy.
Because
Yes, because
they have such a riches of young arms there, dude.
That's a good question.
They didn't even need, like, Verlander, you know what I mean? Like, he's legit. He's going to win the Cy Young, but, dude, to pay what, you know, what he's going to, what his price tag is going to be when Houston already has a plethora of arms, and you know they probably got some coming in the in the system, too. So that'll be interesting. So do they need Verlander is the question.
Great.
And would they pay top dollar because they already have the arms that they have?
That's a phenomenal question. All right, I'm going to go to a guy who I think at the end of this free agency season should actually send a nice handwritten thank you note to Freddie Freeman. Can you guess who I'm talking about? I'm kind of 6 degrees from separation.
Swansby. Dansby Swansby. Dansby Swanson.
Call him Swansby.
Dansby Swanson.
Call him Swansby from now on.
Swansby, yes. Baby. Swansby.
And why do you think I say that? Because of this. They screwed up with, like, their guy. They looked really bad. No offense to Olsen, who is great. I think he's a great player. I think he's a great contributor. I would take Olsen on my team any day of the week, but not over Freddie Freeman, who literally was your guy. Egg on your face. And now you look at Dansby Swanson. First of all, came from being considered one of the worst first draft picks. Like, they got shit on for, like, he got shit on. When he got drafted, that dude is a leader, and I would argue
the Diamondbacks.
Yeah, and I would argue like one of the two or three best defensive shortstops in the game, bro. Swanson, and one of the biggest leaders in the game. You have to re-sign him. I don't care what anybody says.
His OPS this year was a 121 OPS plus, which means 100 for all the fans out there. 100 is the league average. So if you're at a 120, that means you're way above league average.
Got it.
One of the best defensive shortstops out there. Started hitting for power these last couple years, you know, big time power, hits for average, clutch player. Like, you know, I think the only reason the Braves aren't bringing him back, and also, too, on the inside on that, Dansby Swanson, every player loves this dude. Loves they want to bring him back. He's a leader. He's the guy that you want. But the bottom line is they got that young kid, Vaughn Grisham, that shortstop, who's a stud. So that's one of those things where they've locked up all those guys. And they're going to let Swanson walk.
Just call him Swanson.
Because they got Vaughn Grissom there that, you know, is a young kid. They don't have to pay for a few years. But Swanson's going to be he's going to look good somewhere. And that's a good thing, dude. You're getting a lot of bang for your buck there, bro. You're getting a lot of bang. If you sign Swanson, you're not going to pay the rates of Turner and probably Bogarts. And you're going to get getting an elite shortstop.
Okay, last one. We're going to play agent. We're going to play this guy's agent, Carlos Rodon, okay?
Yeah.
Here's how I play my question to you. As his agent, do you get him done early and get him out of the way, or do you sit on your ass until somebody gets to Grom and then let the offers come as probably the second guy behind him?
Yeah.
Or Verlander.
I think you'd like to see DeGrom set the market of what, and Verlander. You got DeGrom and Verlander.
Right.
Sitting out there, and you got Kershaw too. But Kershaw, I'd be shocked if he doesn't go back to the Dodgers.
I can't imagine.
But he's from Texas.
Yeah,
I'm just saying he's from Texas.
You I know, but I think he's a legacy guy. Kind of think he likes a legacy. I think it's pretty special to be. I was a Dodger for my whole life. I don't know.
Right, right. No, I definitely think so. But Rodon, man, Texas is going to be in hard. Chris Young, he's coming for pitching. He wants pitching. Who else is going to be in? Wait, I just said it. I think the Phillies will be in. The Mets will be in.
Oh, good.
The Mets will be in on Rodon because if DeGrom walks, you got to fill that hole with a stud.
Yes.
And for me, Rodon's a stud, man.
Yep.
And he would fit so nicely into that rotation. So I think if DeGrom walks from New York, the Mets are going to go heavy in on Rodon.
Yeah. You know what nobody's talking about? Like, why wouldn't the Yankees go after DeGrom? Think about that 1-2.
Yeah, yeah. What are you thinking about the health of DeGrom? Like he's what is he? He's the age too. Is he 30?
He's 35. He's getting up there.
33 or 30. Yeah. I think he's 35.
But the couple things about that one, I think if I read correctly, like I think his arm has not been used as much on a pro level because I think he came up a little later, right? Remember everybody was talking about Harvey, and. Wheeler, and it's like, wow, this DeGrom guy's pretty good too. And he was the best. He is the best out of all of them. And he's got that big body. He's got, like, pretty tight mechanics. Everybody, but he gets hurt. That's my whole thing with signing the ace. Because
yeah.
he only pitches every five. Your ace, I get it. You want him. I mean, honestly, if I would like, if I signed DeGrom, I wouldn't. This is a stupid thing, but I don't hate this, in my opinion. Why not? I know every game counts, but start DeGrom in May. You sign him, his first pitch. Start. His first pitch is in May. Right. Seriously, if he's going
to get ready, make sure he's healthy.
Take your time, or if I sign like a guy like DeGrom, I'm going 6-man rotation for the first month and a half of the season, or something like that.
Well, dude, you know what? That's funny you say that. That makes me think of, like, LeBron and some of these NBA guys.
That's what they do, yeah.
They coast, and all of a sudden, they know they're going to make the postseason. Then they, boom, they turn it on, get the seed they want, and next thing you know, they dominate in the postseason.
There you go. Anyway, all right. Well, we did it, man. We like got a lot of stuff going on today.
Yeah, dude, you got action with the 33rd team, don't you?
Yeah, I
got
to run.
Have you talked to Michael Vick yet? Have you ever done one?
Yes, I have.
I like that guy.
Cool.
Good guy.
Very nice. Very nice. That's everybody's awesome, so nice. Very, very nice people. They're very Casey-like people I've been working with.
All right, Chinch. Thanks, nice. Bro. Appreciate it. Very right, Chinch Amino-like.
Big weekend plans for you? Anything?
Yeah, dude, my Uncle John's coming into Pittsburgh. My dad's brother. My dad's brother's coming into Pittsburgh. Just saw my dad. My dad's doing very well. Excellent. Thanks for the prayers. Excellent. Every day getting a little better, but my Uncle John is in town. My dad's only brother. Let's go for the weekend. That'll be fun.
Excellent.
Picking him up at the airport. So, yeah, things are good, man. We got action. My buddy Mike Junko tonight in this semifinals of the Whippeel against Bethel Park. Let's go, Junkman. Right.
Let's go, man.
And, all's well, dude. What about you, Chinch? What's going on this weekend?
Nothing, and I can't wait.
Nothing good, nothing. Dude. Just relax.
Yes, just chill out.
Tell Tony and Ants to lay off the throttle, give you a couple days off real nice. You know what I'm saying?
There you go. All right, brother.
All right, brother.
Have a great weekend. Man.
Okay, everybody, everyone have a great weekend. Great. Thanks for tuning in.
Yes.
See you Monday.
See you.
See you, brother.